Dr. Michael Teo, and I have this proposal, an idea how to solve the native customary land dispute in state of Sarawak in Malaysia. Sabah and the Sarawak are two of the East Malaysian states of Malaysia, which is formed by 13 states. 11 of the states are in West Malaysia, called Semenanjung Malaysia. Sarawak area is 30 million acres. Semenanjung, West Malaysia, is 32 million acres. So, area-wise, the whole Sarawak is almost as big as West Malaysia. There in Sarawak is a long-standing dispute between the natives, mostly the Ibans in the rural areas, with the government and with the companies. There is a lot of plantation of palm oil in Sarawak, and a lot of this land is actually given to the companies. The natives are not happy. The Ibans in the rural areas, majority of them living in long houses, are not happy because they have been farming in the rural areas for many, many years, for decades. Most of them are slash and burn farmers. They will cultivate one area. After a few years, when the soil is not fertile, they will move to another area. So over the years, there are a lot of lands that has been cultivated around the longhouses. And even presently, there are a lot of palm oil and fruit trees around the longhouses. The dispute arises when the government gives a piece of paper to the company. This is called the PL, provisional lease. This paper means the land belongs to the company. And whenever the PL is given to the company have the right to go into the land where the natives have been farming for decades. And this is where the dispute is, because the company owns the land, but the natives say that they have been there for decades and they have trees and fruit trees and palm oil plants to show that they have been there. But when they go to the native court, they always lose the court case because the PL, provisional lease, is given to the company, not to the natives who are there. The companies may be registered in Kuching, in Cebu, and the company people do not stay there. It's the natives who stayed in the rural areas and farming over there. So that is a long-standing dispute. There have been protests, there have been fights, there have been killing of activists, there have been 400 court cases piling up in the native court against the government, against the company which gets the PL. So this problem actually is not confined to Sarawak. In West Malaysia or Semenanjung Malaysia, they have solved the problem of land among between the government and the people. In West Malaysia, they are the Malays majority. And the Malays in a scheme which is highly successful over the years is called the Felda scheme. The Felda scheme is each Malay family gets 10 acres of land. They are given 10 acres of land which they own. And there are 112,000 Felda families living in the plantations in West Malaysia. And Felda acquires 2 million acres from the 32 million which consists of West Malaysia. And these feudal families are very happy because each of the 112,000 families now are able to live on the farm and profit from it by growing palm oil or other fruit trees. And this is highly successful. That is why in West Malaysia, the Malays do not go and protest. The Malays do not have conflict with the company. The government is generous enough to give them the land with the title. So there is no dispute between the natives in West Malaysia, the Malays, farmers, against the government or the company, because the company does not get the land. On the other hand, in Sarawak, the companies and the state gets the land. And the state will sell these plantations which the natives have been farming for decades to the company, and that is where the fight comes in. There are lots of protests, lots of fights, and company cars have been burned. This problem is there for 40 to 50 years. Every longhouse community is having problem like this because they do not own the land. The government wants to give the land to the longhouse people, but this is not giving to them. It is rented to them. They don't own the land. They can use the land, but the government can take back the land anytime the government wants. And this is not agreeable to the longhouse people in the rural areas, because let's say 10 years later or 15 years later, when the trees are producing fruit, the government has a right to take away the land and give it to the company. And that is why the natives are not happy with the solution that is proposed to them. They can use the land but don't own the land. This is survey under Section 6. The rural inhabitants, mostly the Ibans, living in 4,500 longhouses are not happy with this solution. They want to own the land. So looking back at West Malaysia, they have solved the problem with Felda scheme. And I'm proposing the same scheme to the longhouses, residents, inhabitants in rural Sarawak. There are 4,500 longhouses. Each longhouse has 25 families or 25 doors. There are 90,000 families altogether in these 4,500 longhouses. If you give 10 acres to each family, just like in West Malaysia, Felda scheme, you only need about 1 million acres. This is actually half the size of Felda. Felda managed to get 2 million acres from the government of West Malaysia to do the farming. I'm proposing the Sarawak government give 1 million acres out of the total area of 30 million for the natives in order to do the palm oil or whatever farming they want to do. Each family will get exactly 10 acres, so there is no dispute or no fight or no jealousy between the families. This is a better way of giving out the land, according to the Felda style, according to the number of the families. Each family has exactly the same as the other family, so there will be less dispute. The other good thing about this is the Malaysian government, the Sarawak government, actually want to increase the number of people going into farming. There are 7% of population in Malaysia doing farming, and Malaysian government policy is to increase this number because there's a lot of unemployment even among graduates. So this is a good way to increase the number of farmers in Sarawak by giving them, each rural family, 10 acres of land. Right now, there is unemployment all over Sarawak. 60,000 natives are actually working in Singapore, and probably another 60,000 is in working in West Malaysia. Because they do not own the land, there is no incentive to stay here in Sarawak. So they will go overseas and work in Singapore, in Kuala Lumpur. So the local government actually has a policy to increase the plantation in Sarawak rapidly over the next few years from 2.5 million acres to 5 million. That is a good project. So inside this project, I'm proposing that 1 million acre should be given to the 4,500 longhouses where they can stay in the rural areas and do the farming. This is actually in line with the policy of the government to enable the farmers to get jobs. Presently, there are not enough foreign workers from Indonesia to come and help the company harvest the fruits. So these palm oil fruits, when they are ripe, after 2 weeks, if it's not harvested from the tree, it will be rotten. It will go rancid and it has to be discarded. We have a big problem in Sarawak presently. We are unable to employ the Indonesians because the economy in Indonesia is better and they refuse to come and work in the plantation in Malaysia. Companies are losing billions a year with fruits that cannot be harvested because there are not enough workers. And yet we have a lot of local people who are not on the scene, who are not employed, working in Kuala Lumpur and Singapore. So if we have a lot of these natives living in the rural areas and looking after their own farms, these natives, they can be the extra source of labor to the company nearby. So after harvesting the fruits in their 10 acres, these families can work part-time for the plantations who are short of workers, whose fruits are dropping and unharvested because it's rotten. That will solve the problem for the company. If the natives are given land, they will not fight with the company. They will not protest. They will not burn down the company car. They will not threaten the workers of the company. And that will solve the native native land conflict in Sarawak, which so far has escalated because the government did not want to give them titles to the land. The government only wants to allow them to use the land but do not own the land, and so it doesn't solve the problem. On top of that, the Sarawak government actually wants a lot of these graduates also to go to work in the farms, because a lot of graduates are unemployed at the present time, and they cannot get employment, and they are doing odd jobs, and they are going to the cities like in Miri. They are squatters because they have no jobs, they have no proper housing, and it makes the situation worse because it increases the population of squatters in cities like Miri, Kuching, Cebu. So therefore, this solution actually has many benefits. It benefits the companies because it provides extra manpower for the companies who are unable to get the foreign workers to come in. And with this COVID epidemic, there are zero foreign workers. And a lot of fruits are actually just unharvested and wasted. If these people have the land, 4,500 longhouses, each longhouse can be a source of manpower to the company who is doing the plantation. And it will help both ways. And now, if they have the 10 acres, they can even go and plant whatever they like. My suggestion is that this Musang King durian is a hot sale. It's a billion-dollar industry, and the Chinese market is huge. And in West Malaysia, farmers are making a big income from durian. So why not we adopt this policy and help these people who has 10 acres maybe to go into durian farming, help them to grow, help them to market, and give them a big income from the 10 acres. Because without the land, there is no way that they can do any farming. So this solution has many advantages, and I urge the Sarawak government to consider this way, maybe start a pilot project in 2 or 3 longhouses and see how it works. If it produces good results, if the company and the local people are in a happy situation, and the government find that this actually is the solution that the natives want, then we can gradually increase the scope of this project, so that 4,500 longhouses residents can actually participate in this program. Only 1 million acres are needed. There are 2.5 million acres in plantation in palm oil. Another 1 million is only 3.5 million. Actually, the government wants to increase it to 5 million. So there is a lot of scope, and we make use of this project to give employment to the natives in Sarawak. And I am sure that the residents in the longhouse, when they have the land, they will be very happy with the Sarawak government, because this project has worked very well in West Malaysia in the feudal scheme. And I urge the Sarawak government, consider this project and have the heart to help our local Sarawak people, because our land is huge. It's as big as West Malaysia. Our population is only 3 million. West Malaysia population, 24 million. We are actually 8 times smaller in population. Therefore, we can be quite generous with the land to give to the local people, give them a title, that's what they want, so that the next generation can benefit from the plantation and the fruit trees which they are going to plant. Because the lifespan of a palm oil can be up to 30 years. So if you threaten to take away the land, there is no incentive for them to plant. Give them a title, 99 years, and then they can plan forward. This is my proposal, which I'm going to propose to Sarawak government to solve this long-standing dispute about native customary land. Thank you very much.